Loose ball in the Texas end.
We got two pushes early, and Colorado, it looks like they're going to let him play.
So they're going to be able to settle up their offense here. Look for number 22, Saddell, number 13, Doherty on the attack. And then they got Cranston and White in the midfield, 55 and 17 respectively. Also number 8, Haynes. So some firepower here on the Colorado offensive end.
I like the circle offense to start, Coach Barrett, just to get the ebb and flow of the game, get the sticks sharp, and to see what Texas is going to do. Obviously, we know that the teams haven't played before. It's good to get a look at your opponent, kind of size them up, and see which guys you're going to be able to get a run on.
Yeah, absolutely. And here it goes. Here it looks like the first push Colorado's going to make here. Big hard dodge coming up top here. Number 8, right-handed dodge, throws down. They move it through to the attack here. And here comes short corner dodge with number 55, moves it up top. Aaron, pass goes away.
We got offsides on White. We're going to go back.
White attackman stepping on the line, so we're going Colorado ball here. And here we go, Colorado retaining possession.
Yeah, everything was right with that last possession, Coach Barrett. Except I thought as soon as they spun that ball, they should have came right back to where it came from, where they had the overload, and they could have attacked that side instead of trying to make a long pass up top.
Colorado with the ball on the side, throws it up top to 55. Here comes back up to number 8. Big tall alley dodge here, coming to his right hand, stops. Comes back to his right. Puts it behind. Dodge from X from 22, comes to his left hand. Throws back up top to 17, big shot wide. It's gonna stay with Colorado on the shot back up. Texas getting their matchup set here. Here comes the restart. 55 carrying the ball down. He's got a short stick on him. Passes it. Ball's down. Texas fighting for the ground ball. Colorado picks up the ball again. Moves it to the opposite side. Number 8 with number 17, long pole in Texas on him. Passes it down. Ball comes back up to 17. Steps in, passes it back up top to number 8. Here comes 8 down the alley, left-handed. Ball gets knocked out of his stick before he can get the shot off.
Good backup.
His possession stays with Colorado.
It's tough dodger, Coach Barrett, but I don't know if that's what you want to do, is dodge up the middle of a defense in a game like this. You've got a lot of big guys out on the field.
If you're going to go
to
the middle of the field, you got to get that shot off fast before the defense collapses on
you. Absolutely. But before you hit 8 yards, that ball's got to be out of your stick.
Here comes number 7 around the cage, shot wide, picked up by number 3 in Colorado. Shot 22.
And I like that shot. It was a double screen right there. I think, he's about 10 out. I see no problem with a shot.
Just didn't get
shot
through the screen. I think he hit his own attackman there. And now we get a bad pass, goes out of bounds, and we got Texas on the clear. So let's see if Texas can get the ball over the midfield line and run their first offensive possession here.
Looks like a match feet right now ride with Colorado.
Texas is out of their end. Now they got to get a touch in the box, and they get it to 12. Ball's down. You can't hang on to it. Ball's still down. 12 gets it, saves it, throws it into the offensive end. Colorado possesses. Now they're coming back down the clear.
He's got to look at his head man right in front.
Flag is down.
So it looks like Colorado's going to go up on the man up for an illegal body check.
So we got Colorado on the extra man here with a illegal body check for 1 minute on the number 3 defenseman for Texas. .10:50 to place in the first quarter, 0-0 game, Colorado. First extra man opportunity of the game. They come out in that open set. Ball's getting moved around. And here comes rangy. Seven, cuts into the crease.
Texas is a little rangy. I think that's got Colorado a little rattled. They're a little bit farther out than they'd like to be. That's
big
certainly
shot,
not the shot.
Hits
that,
a defenseman, goes out of bounds. Colorado stays with it.
Certainly not the shot that you want on a man up from out there, but
Colorado working out of a 14 set. They drag to a 1-3-2 now. And the pass just goes out of bounds.
Yeah, and again, Coach, you know, we talk about this throughout the day. It's make the easy pass. There's the, you know, where's the advantage of throwing down the X in that situation? And what's gained by it, you know? Risk versus reward is such an important part of this
game.
What
an athletic play right there from the number 12 midfielder.
Great
for Colorado.
Check.
They take a shot in transition but don't have backup, and it's going to be Texas ball.
What a great check from number 18 Roderick Mayberry on that, too. He just saved a high chatter goal right there.
Bad pass by the Texas Longhorn goalie. Throws it out of bounds. Going to stay Colorado ball.
Again, just once again, Coach, what about the parity in lacrosse and the area, the geography that we're talking about here? Texas and Colorado. It's just amazing.
Playing in Greenville, South
in
Carolina.
Greenville, South Carolina. The growth of the sport in Colorado, we know, with Denver University and Colorado College, and they've been around for quite a while and have been successful. Texas is just starting to boom with very, very good lacrosse players. Programs like the Iron Horse Lacrosse Club in Dallas, ran by former Syracuse alum Chris Saran, done a phenomenal job with these kids and pushing them to the Division I level. Right now, there's kids all over from all over the state of Texas in Division I NCAA, and what we're seeing out here is just an unbelievable product of the coaching that's going on in these non-traditional areas.
So Texas remains with the ball here, takes a shot, goes wide. They're going to stick with the backup. So their first offensive possession comes with about 9 minutes in the first quarter. So they're down to 8:20 here, and they're going to run a. Coach is calling for a set play here. So let's see what comes out of this.
Well, he's throwing
tacking
a lot
an X,
of
comes
lumber.
Hard to his left hand, throws across crease. Great feed to number 22, 24-22. Big goal by Siddell. Nope, sorry.
Hebert
from Texas to get out to a 1-0 lead over here over Colorado. Just 8 minutes to go in the first quarter. We got 1-0 Texas.
I didn't see the need for the slide on that, Coach. Did you? And the slide actually interfered with his own man.
Yeah, no, I thought he was playing good position right there. They sent the slide, and that just created a back door on the backside there with the two filling in and not anybody able to come back down to help out. So 1-0 Texas on the board. They're pushing it now. They're pushing the tempo. Texas wins an opening faceoff here after the goal, and now they have the ball on offense. Texas with their second midfield on now. Texas with a big dodge up top, number 4 with the dodge, feeds inside.
Great look, got a hand. That's one you got to have. Oh, you still got it. That's
4 got it back with a great save by the Colorado goalie. Again, Colorado goalkeeper is an All-American here in the MCLA.
Coach Barrett, impressed with the size of the Colorado defense?
Absolutely. I think they got good size. It looks like they got some athletic kids out there. Goalie's moving well from pipe to pipe right now. So it looks like they got a tough unit out there. This is shaping up to be what looks to be a great game.
That they're not afraid to lay the lumber either, are they out there? They're really putting it on these guys.
Very aggressive to start.
Texas attack is a little smaller, considerably smaller than the Colorado defense, and they're really putting the sticks on them.
Colorado, Texas on the invert here. Colorado matched up with a short stick, held their slide, and he just beat him to the goal. And now we got 2-0 Texas.
Sam Jones, number 24. Sam Jones comes around the corner and takes that extra step, beats his man, and buries it in the corner.
Texas goal scored by number 6, Spencer Price.
Check that. Goal scored by number 6, Spencer Price.
Spencer Price was one of the the players that Coach Garrigan told us to look out for, having a great year on the attack for Texas, and there he is getting on the board for a 2-0 Texas lead. Colorado faces off with a long pole, number 50, and he wins the draw. Let's see who picks up the ball here.
Oh, we got a little bit of scrum in the middle. Everybody let go. Everybody's still friendly.
Texas picks up the ground ball, pushes transition, shot wide by 24.
All right. Hi, Al. I like the shot. I don't know if he knew he had the backup, but the backup was there, and good time to take a shot right off the screen.
So, after Colorado really controlling the ball for the first 6 minutes of the quarter, ever since then it's been really all Texas on offense now, and they've come away with 2 quick goals here, and they got a 2-0 lead, and now they got the ball again back out on offense. Long offense getting back to work. Here in a 1-3-2 set, here comes a pick over. Number 12 sweeps off it to his right hand, puts it back in his left, throws down to the attack, throws to 24 coming over to his left hand, maintains possession, moves it back. Back up top to 14. Over to the wing, hitch and go off the left wing. Back over to 6, shot wide. Staying with Texas.
I just like to see those shots in there overhand. It's so much more difficult for a goalie to make those saves, Coach, when you're shooting overhand, especially when it's it's going to be on cage when you're shooting directly in the middle, straight overhand.
Absolutely. Got to make the goalies work a little bit to make some saves. 22 with the ball back up top. Guarded by number 50, moves it over to 14. Sticks in his left hand, comes down the alley to his right. Swings the ball behind. Gets it back up top. Bad pass, deflects off stick, goes down to the Colorado attack. Colorado picks up the ball off the ground, number 33. Flips it to number 3, the midfielder, and he's gonna carry it down inside the box. Gets a touch.
That was a nice play by number 33, Dan Gorman for Texas. Just nice little flip, heads-up play, knowing he's got pressure on his back and getting rid of that ball, getting it upfield.
So Colorado back on offense now. Got their midfielders in. They're all set. Starting off in that open set. They're cutting to the crease now. Here comes back up top. Big alley dodge, 55. Carries it through X, moves it. Got a man open on the wing. Shot
great
and a goal.
Shot.
That is great offense right there.
22.
Dodge the one alley, throw it down, hit the guy in the opposite wing for a shot. Sticks it in the top right corner. We have a 2-1 ball game.
Michael Rizzuti with the goal, number 3, with the assist from number 22, Jack Ibert. What a great shot. You know what? Yeah, that goal, Coach Barrett, started out with one of the things that I just love to preach to my kids about dodging, taking your man as far as he's willing to go. And that initial dodge, he took his guy as far as he was willing to go, all the way behind the cage.
Wow, big face-off win by the long pole, comes down and takes a great shot, but the goalie makes a good save, so we're coming back Texas ball. Texas with the clear. Texas setting up their offense here, getting their offensive middies on the field. Number 4 catching it as he subs onto the field. Big hard alley dodge, comes back to his left, comes back to his right now, comes down the alley, stops, puts it back in his left, moves it. Ball staying up top. Ball's at X at 24, moves it up top. 15, over to 4. Pick coming from the near attackman. And Texas just throws the ball out of bounds, and we're going to Colorado clear.
So a little bit too much mustard on that hamburger. Slipped right out.
Pass gets deflected down. Goalie scoops it up as it was rolling in front of the crease. Gets it to a midi, and they leg it out.
Got it.
Ball remains with Colorado on the offensive end here. 2 minutes, getting down to 2 minutes in the first quarter. We have a 2-1 Texas lead. Colorado moving the ball around. Here comes a big out dodge up top, 46, dodging hard down the alley, right-handed. Ball gets swatted down by a defenseman. Colorado remains in possession, picks up the ground ball. Ball gets moved. Here comes 22 with the dodge, hard to his left hand, and a shot and a score. 2-2, great dodge by 22. Colorado sticking it low for the game-tying goal, 2-2.
And Riley Seidel, just a great individual effort from starting the dodge from the X, dodging to the high side, probably came up a good 8 yards and ripped that ball.
Great
nice
individual effort.
Away shot.
Great individual effort.
Great
there.
Individual effort. Taking those extra steps, you can't stress it enough to kids. It's just proof. The proof's in the pudding. Proof's on the video right now. That when you take that extra step, you're gonna do something. Good things are gonna happen.
Another big faceoff win by the long pole for Colorado, number 50. That's his third win in a row with the long pole.
That's gonna become a big factor in this game, as we come down to a minute here. Ball possession again. We're seeing it Colorado maintain a pretty healthy, steady level of possessions.
Number 8 went hard to the goal with the stick in his left hand, shot it high. Colorado's got the backup. There's 40 seconds remaining in this opening quarter of play.
Whoa. Wide open man on the crease just took the shot, and about a 10-yard shot. Had his teammate Tyler Doherty wide open on the crease.
Twenty seconds remaining in the quarter. 55 hard right-handed alley dodge shot and a goal. That's 3-2 Colorado scoring.
Jack Cranston.
On big that goal, shot.
And that was a tremendous shot down the alley. I don't think he could paint a prettier picture than that one.
Absolutely. Giving them the one goal lead here with 15 seconds remaining in the quarter. So Texas opening up with a 2-0 lead. Colorado coming back with 3 straight. Now we have a 3-2 ball game. And we have the long pole for Colorado, number 50, out there facing off again. And he wins his fourth one in a row here. He's doing a phenomenal job at the X.
Yeah, really.
10
is.
Seconds left. Let's see if they push it.
They do.
They get
time.
It to 22. He comes in front.
That's a goal.
Big save. Wow. It looked like it was going to squirt behind the goalie, but he gets his stick on it, and that's going to end the first quarter. 3-2 Colorado. We will be back in a short break.
So coming back, we have a stick violation on Colorado's number 22, Seidel. Looks like a depth of his pocket is too deep. It's going to be a one-minute non-releasable penalty. And possession to start the half on this one. That's a game changer right there.
That is, and you know, one of the lucky things for Seidel is that the pocket was just deep, so that means he can adjust it and get it back in the game. Whereas if you know, the head of the stick wasn't right or something was wrong, it would be a 3-minute non-releasable, and the stick would not be allowed back in the game.
And you lose your stick. Goes to the Coach Barrett fund. We keep them underneath the truck.
Absolutely. So here we go, Texas on EMO. Let's see if they can take advantage here. And again, they can score as many as they can here in this minute because it's a non-releasable penalty. So let's see what Texas can take advantage of this.
Yeah, and I think with this coach, you're aggressive but still cautious. You know,
absolutely,
you don't want to blow the opportunity, but you still would like to get two out of it.
Here comes the movement on the offensive end. Guys stepping in the passing lanes. They're moving the ball.
And the one more on that. He's still
there
got it.
There it is, number six.
Oh,
shot. Great save
great
by the
save.
Colorado goalkeeper.
Ate it up.
So now they got to clear it man down.
Nike's showing it. Yeah, a little bit. Coach, I think he showed the shot. He laid that stick out sideways, and that not going to be able to change the plane of the shot that much. And now I pick that up and go, right? Go.
So Texas picks up the ball coming out of bounds. Penalty is seconds away from being released. So the penalty is released, so now we're back to even strength.
That was a great, great ground ball by defenseman for Colorado, number 18, Hayden McLean.
Texas riding hard right now.
I think anytime you come out of those situations, you know, it's so frustrating for a player when you have a minute penalty, non-releasable, and you come out with a clean shot out of that.
Nope.
Yeah, that's frustrating.
So here's Colorado back on offense. Ball's deflected. It's in the middle of the field. Texas looks to pick it up. Picks it up by Colorado 55. Great save by the Texas goalkeeper.
And Texas is legging it down the field right now, clearing it.
That's got to be a hold right there or something.
There's going to be a ward on the Texas player. He drops it. Quick restart, Colorado's ball.
I can't concur on that one, Coach. I got to go with he was trying to get away from the hold. Getting mugged in downtown Greenville.
Yeah. These two teams are playing aggressive, playing hard. Colorado with the ball on the offensive end. 3-2, Colorado lead. Here comes a dodge from number three. Moves it up top. Five moves it up. Here comes number 12. Dodging to his left hand. Comes back to his right and scores!
Great.
4-2, Colorado.
Great shot. Great finish. Great placement on that shot. It's just too tight. Right placement, goalie's not getting to that ball. It's just asking too much on for your goalie to get to that one.
Dodge hard to his left, came back to his right to stick the shot. 4-2, Colorado. Face off, procedure. Texas ball. Procedure on Colorado, Texas ball. That's their first of the half.
Yeah, Texas standing around a little bit. Now that's you guys need outlets.
37 dodging hard to his left.
Kind of leaving him out on an
gets
island
deep,
right
moves
now.
Moves it to X. Come back around. Left hand feeds in front. What a save by the Colorado goalkeeper.
Unbelievable.
That's why he's an All-American, folks.
Absolutely. I mean, that was just like getting punched right in the face by Mike Tyson. And you know,
standing there.
And it was unbelievable.
Texas really riding hard here.
Great up and over clear. Colorado pushing it.
Well, it's going on down in Colorado's box. They're a little crazy going on. And it was a little disorganized for a second. I don't think they were sure of their personnel. And I think that's
Texas with the clear.
They got caught shorthanded for a second.
Texas calling out zero, so let's see what they come out in that. That's their open set, so they're going to go to a circle.
It's creativity. I mean,
so now they cut one to the crease. They're in a 1-3-2 set. Dodge from up top. They get a sweep. Look for the man floating out. That was a nice little play there. Just couldn't connect the pass.
Yeah,
Colorado
little...
picks it up off the ground. They're pushing it the other way.
I like those little opener play. You know, if it was a little bit of more of a touch pass on that, you know, you can't force those things in there. If they got a... Those are set plays, the little outside openers that... You got to place the ball. Drop it in his bucket.
Colorado
on offense here. Ball's down. Texas defender. They're hockeying it around. Colorado picks it up. A lot of body contact going on in the back end of the field here. Colorado comes away.
You know,
timeout, Colorado.
I don't know about you, Coach. I'm seeing two totally different defenses. I'm watching on one end in Colorado, a very, very physical, big defense that throws a lot of checks. And then I'm looking at the Texas group that plays a lot more position, a lot less body, you know, they'll throw the checks a little bit, but certainly not a lot. They don't take a lot of chances.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you got two different styles here, and that's the fun part about playoff lacrosse is to see what happens when those two styles match up, to see which team's going to come out about. Right now, you got Colorado with a 2-goal lead, 4-2, with 9 minutes and 20 seconds left in the second quarter.
I remember a great defenseman, Spencer Wims, who he was great when he never threw a check. And every time he threw a check, he'd always get himself in trouble.
Yeah, he tried to make up with his athleticism, and you can watch him play with the Charlotte Hounds now, so he's still got a good career going.
Spencer down in the area still. Coaching up at Belmont Abbey.
All right, so coming back from break, live here with the Division I first round playoffs, the MCLA National Championship Tournament, live from Greenville, South Carolina. We want to say thank you to our sponsors, Lax World and the City of Greenville, for putting on this event. Colorado with the ball, up two. Colorado moving the ball. Big shot, wide. Colorado's got backup.
Quick
moving
start, and I look for a shot right now. Oh, I don't know what that, I'm not exactly sure.
And they called that a shot.
They're giving him a shot.
Wow.
I don't know.
Colorado maintains possession there. Not much out of the Texas coaching staff either.
She shoots harder than that.
Colorado putting the pressure on offensively here, stepping in. Looks like Texas is in a zone.
Big shot by 22. Big
what
save.
What a save.
He
what
gets his
save.
Own rebound. Another yeah. save. So 22 had two shots right there. Both saved by the Texas goalkeeper.
What a great individual by Texas goalkeeper, number 10, Jordan Lee.
Texas pushing transition shot. Bounce shot over the goal.
Texas maintains possession.
Jordan Lee just changed the entire face of the transition game all on his own down there by making a save, then taking the ball away, picking a ground ball up. What's the call here?
So Texas rides, gets a turnover, picks up the ground ball. Looked like they had number situation, and the coach called a timeout. So Texas will come back out of the timeout with the ball. 7:52 remaining here in the second quarter.
4-2 Colorado right now. Yeah, that was an interesting timeout call, Coach.
Yeah, I mean, you know, even the players looked like they were a little frustrated there, but I don't blame Coach. He really just wanted to have possession there. They haven't really had a good offensive possession where they could run a set play or a set offense. So I think he's just trying to get them in a groove and settle down the chaos a little bit.
Chaos is a good word right now. It started out very controlled. Everybody had their heads on, and generally the games don't start like that. Generally people are all amped up and they make the mistakes early. The mistakes are starting to come later in the game, which is a little uncharacteristic.
And we got very physical play. I mean, both teams are really getting after each other, and you know, so that's going to bring some errors when you got some physical play out there.
Oh, absolutely.
All right, so Texas coming back out of the timeout, down 4-2 here with 7:52 remaining in the second quarter. Texas ran a set play, threw the ball away. It goes down to the Colorado attack. They pick up the ground ball. Now they're pushing it down there. Ball's down again. Texas picks it up. Moves it. That's going to roll out of bounds, and that's going to stay. That's going to be Colorado ball. Colorado on the clear here. Texas with a three deep ride. They give it to a short.
I didn't see the offsides on that, Coach, but
it looks like the far referee's coming over to correct himself. The far referee had three guys back, it looked like. All right, so it is offsides, and it's going to be Texas ball. So offsides there by Colorado, and they're clearing it. Now we've got Texas ball.
Four to two, Texas lead with just under 7 minutes remaining here in the first half.
Texas looking inside, cutter 14, and a feed
finish.
And a goal. Great off-ball movement
John
by number 14.
Jackson. What a great finish off-ball by John Jackson, number 14.
4-3 now, Colorado with the one-goal advantage with 6:41 remaining here in the first half. What a back-and-forth contest we've had here so far.
Yeah, this has been something else. This has been exciting, and it's the ebb and flow of the game keeps just changing. And
50 with another face-off win.
That's got to be, what, his sixth in a row?
I would say so. He's having a phenomenal day. He's not afraid to handle either, so he'll stay out there as much as he can, play some offense.
And, you know, that's having a long pull up that position. It's usually it's more for a defensive posture to take the ball away from a good faceoff guy. You don't usually see guys that are that quick to the draw with a pull like that.
He's a big reason why the score is what it is right now, though.
Oh, absolutely. The possession time that he's given his team is incredible.
Colorado back on the offensive set. Number 12 with the ball. Moves it up top to 46. Gets it down the side. 22 with the ball at X. Swings it back down the 9. Ball gets backed up top. Number 12 over to 5 on the wing. Moves it back up to 5. 5 steps in. Takes a big hit and a shot.
I don't know.
And they're going to get 18 for following through on that big hit after 5 took a shot.
Yeah.
Illegal body check by number 18, so he's going to be in the box for 1 minute.
I thought he led with his shoulder. If it was late, okay. I don't know if that was high.
Well, Colorado on the EMO here again, and you know that's why they wear the stripes, and we're up here in the booth calling the game. So
that's right.
See if Colorado can capitalize here on this extra man. They weren't able in the first one, so let's see what they bring out this time. They're starting that zero set, that open set again. And here comes the movement. Two cutters into the crease. Looked like a right-handed wheel shot was wide.
I think it's tough here. They got number 17, who's obviously a right-handed player. Texas doesn't need to extend out to him.
Big shot wide. Number 7 picking it up again off the end line here and still on the extra man.
Because of when the ball gets to him, he's got to turn his whole body to get his shot off.
Throws down, number 7 comes up, takes a shot wide. It's going to stay Colorado ball. About 15 seconds remaining. Ball gets up to 22. He catches it, but it falls out of the back of his stick on a shot. Texas is going to clear.
Oh, great
back
trail check
there. Ball's down. Colorado stays with it, picks it up.
Carries it over and he pushes
two
up to 18.
Poles,
looks for a
give and
go.
Oh, no backup.
No backup. What a great give and go by two long poles in transition right there.
Yeah, that was fun to watch. I don't mind that at all. It's still early in the game. It's 4-3. Take a chance. Obviously, the attackman is there. It's the attackman's job to get back there. But that's still some creativity on those poles part.
Texas throws away the ball on a clear, so it's going to be Colorado ball again. 4:07 remaining in the first half.
I got to think the turnover ratio right now is much heavier on Texas's end. Do you agree on that, Coach? I think they're 2-1 in the turnover category.
Yeah, I would agree. Colorado doing a nice job really possessing here. Moving the ball around. Getting what they want. Finding the matchup they want. Now they're going to initiate offense. Here comes 46. Hard down the alley. Splits right to left. Comes to the middle and takes a wide shot. It's backed up by Colorado. Shot blocked by a defenseman. Gold ball. We had a conduct foul on Texas. I think he got hit with a shot and said a bad word, so they're going to give it back to Colorado. Getting down to 3 minutes here in the first half. 3 minutes remaining.
Tempo certainly slowed. Both teams came out really, really ready to brawl, and I think they felt each other out. I think they feel like they're equal, relatively equal opponents, and are
good ball
are valuing
movement.
The ball much better.
Feed inside to number 3, off the crossbar.
Boy, like to see him bury that low and away.
That ball's headed to the hot dog stands. So we're getting a new ball back in. Colorado back in play. They got the invert here.
New hot
12
dogs
feeds
in
it inside
nice
to number
shot.
3. Nice shot and a goal. 12-3. So that makes it a 5-3 game, Colorado. Very smart.
Steven.
Smart, steady offense right there.
Tyler Doherty with the finish. And, I think the assist on that was the most impressive part of the play. Just drawing the man, drawing the slide. The second slide definitely, you know, came way too late.
Face off goes to Texas. 5-3, 2:20 left in this first half. Timeout White, so Texas with a timeout here. See if they could set up some offensive play here. Down two goals with 2:20 left in the first half.
Well, Coach Barrett, right now, we've seen the last two games that have been a lot of action, a lot of up and down action. Not a lot of scoring, and I think, you know, we've seen the previous game, we saw two great goalies. I think we have, again, we've got one light out goalie, and very, very impressed so far with the Texas goalie.
Yeah,
so.
Absolutely. I mean, both guys keeping their teams in the game, obviously with a 5-3 score. There hasn't been too many good looks, but there's been a lot of shots. So the goalies are making the saves they're supposed to, and the defense are forcing the offensive guys into some bad angle shots that are forcing some wide shots and making it a little bit even easier on the goalie, too. So we'll see what happens here with 2:20 left in this first half. Texas with the ball, down two goals. So this would be a big possession here to see if you can get a 5-4 game going into the half, Coach.
Yeah, I would. I'd treat this as the two-minute warning. Play this 2 minutes out, try to bag one inside of 30 seconds, 20 seconds, and go into halftime feeling good about yourselves. There's certainly no rush. And the worst case scenario is you rush something, make a bad pass, just like that. And now Colorado's going and playing offense again.
Yep, and they got a minute and 56 to see if they can extend the lead here. So Colorado's got to clear it. They got a short stick with the ball. And he throws it away, so it's going to be Texas ball.
Hey, let's make it, take it. Down in Greenville, South Carolina.
Texas with the ball here. Minute and 45 left in the first half. Texas running a 2-4 offense.
Yeah, it's very bizarre. I
here we go, and there's some white-handed reel. They cut inside. Shot wide,
great.
And Colorado
hustle.
Goalie makes it to the ball.
Hey, that's why he's an All-American, right? That's the intangibles. The little things that you do that get you past the next guy.
Short stick picks it up off the end line. He's going end zone to end zone. He turns back, throws it back to the goalie, who hits a short stick in the middle of the field, but then hits another short stick, 55, and they're clearing the ball. They're going to get a touch in the box here.
A minute left, Coach. Do you call a timeout right now? And
yeah, it depends. I mean, if they've got some offensive players trapped on the field here for Texas, I may keep it and let it go, depending if I like my matchups here.
They got the four poles on right now. I don't know.
Here comes a big dodge from Colorado. Shot
and a goal.
Split right to left by number 17. Puts it off stick side.
Matt White, 6-3,
Colorado.
Nice top dodge from Matt White. Lefty rip right in the low corner. Those are those unstoppable shots when you put them in that back corner.
Big goal right there. So here comes the faceoff now. 41 seconds remaining in the half. 6-3, Colorado with the lead. Ball's loose. Texas picks it up off the ground. Gets it to an attackman. There's 30 seconds
you know
left
what?
Here.
Now I'm calling a timeout.
Texas is out of timeouts,
well,
I believe,
right there.
Coach.
They took the two. You are correct on that one, Coach.
20 seconds remaining here. And a bad pass goes out of bounds, so Colorado's going to be setting up their clear with 16 seconds. Let's see if they can get off one quick shot here.
Run to the ball. Run to the ball.
Throw it to a short stick who gets it up the field. He's pushing it. We got 10 seconds.
Plenty of time, eh?
Timeout. Colorado.
Yes.
And there was 7 seconds. The clock's still counting down. It shows two, but I say there's seven.
Yeah, I had it at 7 or 8 as well.
See if the referees get together and talk
that,
here.
Because I think that's important. I mean, I wouldn't bother calling a timeout with 2 seconds left.
Okay, now they got 7 back up on the clock. So 7 seconds, Coach. I think you try to see if you can get an off-ball pick and a cut and a quick feed inside and see if you can get some kind of shot off or maybe
ball.
A quick dodge off the whistle and a shot. I don't know.
Coach Carl from Sonoma State just stopping by, scouting out the game a little bit. Great coach up in Northern California.
So they put 10 seconds on the clock, Coach, they're in. So they actually gave him a few
more
seconds.
You know,
ten seconds.
Now I'm running a play. I have a 10-second play, Coach. You know, I would say with 7 seconds, I'm going to load it up in front of the crease. I'm just going to try to fire one through a screen. But with 10 seconds, that gives me time to run a play.
So let's see what Colorado does. The coach is giving out his final instructions. Ball's on the far side, opposite the bench. And here's a quick dodge. They throw it to X, who looks to the backside. He's coming, 22 turns.
We have no, the clock did not start.
So they're having some clock issues.
Well,
they started at 10. Now they got it back down to 6.
You know,
and they're going to give it back to Colorado?
See, the issue that I have here, Coach, is the referees have the ultimate control of the time on the field. So if they determine now that they just ran off that time, then why they're just
quick
giving
pass
the ball
up top,
back.
17 coming hard down the alley. Shot and a goal with 0 seconds remaining. Now that, let's see if they keep it.
If I'm coaching over for Texas right now.
There is 1 second left, so the goal will stand. That's 7-3. They got to face off before the half. It's just procedure. And we're live back here in Greenville, South Carolina at the MCLA Division I National Championship Tournament. First round matchup between the Texas Longhorns and the Colorado Buffaloes. Colorado with a 7-3 lead. A beautiful day here. You got the Clemson Tiger tent set up. You've got the all the 6 fields here. You got teams from Division I, Division II all over. You got great crowds at home watching the webcast, CB2 and Leanne and all the families back home checking this game out. It's awesome. Right now, Texas winning this first faceoff and coming down on the offensive end here. Let's see if Texas can start getting their way back into this game here. Texas with the ball. Texas with the ball, got the ball behind X, getting it up to the wing, up to number 12. Carries, gets to the 14, popping off the crease. Number 11, coming down. Colorado's defense really packing it in tight, Coach.
Yeah, a little different. Obviously, they made some adjustments at halftime. Didn't feel like they needed to pressure out maybe as much. That was a nice
quick shot. That goes wide. Texas recovers.
Great painting. Painting unassisted. Yeah.
Texas off the end line here.
Brad McNeese saw that all the way. The thing that's impressed me most about him, Coach Barrett, is that he is on everything.
Yeah.
He's on the ball. I mean, the shots that have gone in on him have been great shots.
14 comes down, throws it back up. Man popping off the crease. That's number 6 coming to his right hand. And it doesn't make it through. It dribbles to the goalie, and now they're sitting up there clear. Here comes Colorado.
Probably could use a box, coach, over here.
Box. Good sub for Colorado here. They got to get a touch in the box, and they do. Ball's moving.
I like 50. I like 55. I like his ability to create offense. 17-2. Both of them are hard dodgers. They know what to do. They take long dodges.
It's really a set offense.
It is.
There's not much free movement out of this Colorado. You can tell they practice certain things, and they just go to what they practice. Not a lot of freestyle going on in that offense.
No, it's strong. It's, you know, it starts with a strong dodge, and they take their man, pretty deep into the goal line extended, and then, you know, they know when that slide comes, they're programmed to move the ball, and they're getting good looks.
Here comes Texas back down on the offensive end. They may have a number situation here with a late sub. Oh, but Texas didn't have their offense. Texas picks up the ball in front, and it's a wide shot. Texas picks it up, gets it off the end line here.
You got I believe
number 6 with the ball behind. Moves it up to the wing. Bounce pass. Deflects off the Texas offensive player right into the Colorado stick. They got a 5-on-4 transition here. And he holds onto it and pulls it out. They move it down the X. Still had a little bit of an advantage there. Just didn't take advantage of that, coach.
Surprisingly. I mean, you're up 7-3, and obviously maybe that's what they talked about at halftime is, you know, not to take chances.
Yeah.
But I didn't feel like that was taking much of a chance.
No, but, you know, play smart.
There, you had everything, you had numbers.
The only thing I will say is that was a long pull streaking down, and they probably know their personnel better than I do. So maybe, maybe that's something they didn't want to do there. And
right.
Well, now they have in good possession here on offense, and let's see what they do. 22 dodging hard from X, had a goal earlier like that, feeds, and a wide shot by 7. 22's really making things happen
back there.
And he just busted his butt back to the end line to get the shot back up as well.
Dodges hard, and creating the ability for Jace Gann to get open. Jace has got to flash to the ball, though, not fade to X on that. You don't
Colorado
see a whole lot of goals scored that
here.
Way.
Here comes the offense again. Big heart down the alley. Feeds inside.
That's a feed. Let's see if it goes. And they call it a feed, so that's going to be Texas ball in the clear.
And that Jack Cranston, we've watched him on a couple occasions. He's had nice, strong alley dodges and thrown down. He hasn't made those just kind of no look passes to the inside. And that's one of the first real mistakes I've seen him make today.
Colorado, another great ride. Turns the ball over. They retain possession.
Then this is a time again, just, you know, there's no urgency here. Get your guys out. You don't have numbers.
10 minutes remaining here in this third quarter of the first round of the Division I MCLA National Championships with 7-3 Colorado over Texas right now. Ball's up top with Colorado. Moving it. They're really moving the ball well. Alley dodge 5 throws down. Throws back up. They got to be careful. They don't have a lot of backup behind the cage here if they take a shot, coach. A lot of guys in front of the cage. There goes one back there. Okay. Moving the ball around here, and this 3-3 a little bit. 5 comes back. He's there. Moves it. They really want to get closer than what they're at. They look like they're at 5. Here comes 12 with a shot off the crossbar. And out of bounds, Colorado ball really taking advantage. They're beating the guys to the middle of the field, coach. They're getting to about 8 yards and either holding their shot if a guy's on their gloves or they're taking it if they're not.
Yeah. They're really, it's just been solid possessions.
Unbelievable, and that's 22 again making it happen for Max. Great dodge, feeds 46 up top, catches, finishes, 8-3 Colorado.
Yeah. 22 is Ryan Seidel, and he's been... So he's really been the quarterback for the game today. He's creating transit. He's creating transition in settled offense because he dodges so hard. He's making the slides go. He's not only making one slide go. He's making two, because he's been tripled here the last couple times, and he just knows where the open man is.
Well, he must have fixed his stick from that early penalty he got, because it looks like it's working out well for him right now.
He's on a dime now,
18 clears it, and a great transition play. Two defenders slid up to the point, forced the goalie to come out. The attackman caught it, and the goalie 6-7 yards outside the cage. He wraps it around him for the fourth goal of the game for Texas, and that's an 8-4 game right now, and that's just a little bit of a mishap right there for Colorado, Coach.
Yeah, it was. It was really odd that the goalie got caught so far out of position, you know, for
I wonder about that sometimes. Is he better just to stay in the crease there and just play that as a one-on-one, try to bait a guy to a spot and make the save rather than doing something you're not comfortable in, and that's coming out of the cage and literally making yourself a defender?
Yeah, I mean, you know, the goalie's job is to save the ball, you know, save the ball and clear the ball. And nobody asked you to take the ball away. Nobody asked you to intercept the ball. You know, nobody.
That's just I don't put it all on him. You know, I put it on the defense to force him into that decision.
Right.
You know, he just made a play and just came up short. But again, he's an All-American goalie. And he's been playing lights out when it comes down to that.
He's a tremendous save, and that's what it boils down to.
Oh,
what a
wow!
Rip by 55.
Big bounce shot from 55, caught Texas sleeping off ball, backside. Goalie's putting his hands in the air like, what are we doing defensively here? And that puts Colorado back on the board, 9-4 lead.
That's Cranston again, and between Cranston and Seidel, they both have just really just keep every time Texas does something, they just come back and just break the backs.
I want to give a special thanks to our NSF camera guys here. They've been doing a great job out in the sun. And I tell you what, the sun's hitting them before it's hitting a lot of us, because they're about 20 feet in the air. So they're doing a great job.
Tremendous job by the camera crew out here today. And the ground staff and everybody out here in Greenville.
It's just all hands on deck here today.
All hands on deck. I mean, this is like the USS Ronald Reagan. I mean, this thing is a fine oiled machine today. And the team play has been outstanding as well. There's no disappointment.
I mean, there are
whatsoever.
People around. There are lacrosse fans everywhere, from one sideline to the next, to the booked parking lot, to the tents in the parking lot selling the gear. This is a phenomenal tournament. We got a flag down, and it's going to be an extra man for Texas, and this could be big here, Coach. They score a goal and cut this deficit to 4 with a quarter and still 7.5 remaining. They could put yourselves right back in this game.
They need it. You know, the goal that they just scored, and then having Cranston come down and take that goal back from them, it hurt them. They need this right now. Man up goals, get guys fired up. They're usually good. They're usually pretty goals. They're usually good looking goals. They need it right now.
Because this could make that Texas sideline go crazy. Yeah. And, you know, next thing you know, you win the next faceoff, and we're in a lacrosse game here. So 9-4, let's see what Texas does here. Let's see how Colorado defends it.
Bring out the holsters and the bullets and start firing.
1-3-2 set here. Started in 3-3, cut to the crease. We're in a 1-3-2. A flip play behind. But they fall. They mess the flip up, and the ball's on the ground. There's a battle for a loose ball. Now they got all the defenders
behind.
Now you
need the one more.
Pass the ball up in front, and they hold on to it here on the same side. Redirect the ball, and let's see what happens here. Big check. Defender jumps a lazy pass. The ball's on the ground, going out towards the sideline. And we're going to stay with Texas ball.
I am going to go on a limb and say that that Colorado's defense is just starting to feel so comfortable with their matchups that
Absolutely.
They don't care where they slide to because they know.
It does take a couple quarters, Coach. I mean, you've got teams from Colorado and Texas here who didn't see each other in the regular season, probably not a lot of film on one another.
No.
And now it's get here, and it's like you got to feel them out where, you know, in a traditional matchup, you probably have a little bit of an idea of who you're playing.
Sure.
You've seen some film, or you played them the previous year.
Sure.
You get thrown into a tournament like this, you're playing teams from other side of the country. You really have no idea what you're getting yourself into outside of talking to coaches and getting a little bit of film. So really, you feel it out in the first half of the game.
Yeah, you know, and I mean, you're talking film from who knows what kind of stadium and you know, the quality of the films. I mean, you know, it's when you're talking about the NCAA tournament, you know, all those, everybody knows one another. You know, the 63, 64 Division I teams out there that, you know, everybody knows everybody. This is different. There's a lot of teams in this league, and
transition for Colorado. Shot and a goal. Great job by 42 carrying it down the side. Hits number 11 popping off the crease for a sidearm low-to-low shot, and that will make it 10-4. The Colorado Buffaloes extending the lead to 6.
How about the release by Zach Pendleton on that? Just a smooth release. He picked that spot before he even caught the ball.
Absolutely. I mean, off stick low. Even a great goalie has trouble getting to a shot like that. Pendleton for me.
I'm starting to sense the Texas bench is starting to get a little quiet.
We need to get these guys roaring like that. Those Clemson Tigers over there, they got that Big Ten set up. Those guys are loud, you know. Here we go, back on offense. Number 46 looks like CB2 out here. Looks great. Colorado carrying it down. Just look at all the lacrosse families out here, Coach. Just from the younger sisters to the mothers to the wives to, it's just a great atmosphere here in Greenville today.
Yeah.
On top of the great weather.
Yeah, it really is a great location to pull something like this off. I mean, hats off to the MCLA committee, and logistics that go into making something like this happen, and why Greenville, South Carolina, come here 2 years in a row? Obviously because
it's been successful. Yeah,
it's great.
I also want to say thank you to the families that are allowing all the people to come out here and put in a long day of work. You know, Betsy Durin back in Syracuse, Isabella and Maximus letting their dad come down here and coach this game, and my beautiful wife at home, Leanne, with my son, CB2, allowing us to come out here and give a good 14 hours of lacrosse work in today.
Yeah.
Here's Colorado back on the offensive end, 4-0. Big shot!
Rip.
Big shot with 4 minutes to go to make it 11-4, Colorado, Coach. They're starting to extend the lead.
Yeah.
Does the Texas coach think about a timeout here to just get the guys back in together, talk to them? I mean, you have two. There's 4 minutes left in the quarter. Colorado's been on a 4 or 5 goal run now.
Yeah.
And, instead of just kind of, letting it go, I might take a timeout here, but it doesn't look like he's going to go that route.
I don't know why he's gonna save it. I mean, you got to take the one and just talk to your guys and get their heads back in it, because minus that low to low goal, there really hasn't been much of anything from them out there, and it's just Colorado's just owning the time of possession.
Look at Texas Ride right here. Wow, a lot of physical play in that corner. The refs are letting them go, Coach. That almost looked like a UFC fight down there in that corner for that ground ball.
That was getting a little chippy. It's going to happen. You know, there's a lot of pride. You play all year to get to this, you know, this.
Good poke check by the Texas defender, 44. Ball's on the ground. Let's see who comes up with it here. It's in the Colorado attacking end. Colorado picks it up, moves it up top, moves it one more. Let's see if they get a big dodge here. 53 comes down the alley, right-handed shot. Great save right at the goalie's feet. That's where we talk about changing planes there a little bit, Coach. But
yeah,
he came high overhand, just shot it at the goalie's feet. You know, if you want to get that bounce shot, you got to put it a couple feet in front of him so that ball shoots back out. You want to usually when I'm teaching my guys to shoot bounce shots, we want to aim for the top of the crease.
Yeah, it's gotta be at the top of the dirt. Where the goalies, you know, the goalies stand on their arc.
And it depends on the surface. Right now the grass is dry on a beautiful day. The ball's really coming up. I bet if this field was soaked, it would be more like the worm burners where they just would be skipping along like when you're throwing a rock in the lake and how it skips along. That's what it would look like on a wet field. But here, beautiful field. It's literally like cement when that ball's coming back up off the ground on that big bounce shot. So here's Texas setting some picks. And they had a moving pick here. So they had an interference, and that's going to be Colorado ball.
Moving pick and a shot.
I'm sensing a lot of losing of the life over here in the Texas bench. They've been quiet here for a while. That wasn't the way the game started. And, you know, with Colorado chipping away, they're starting to, you know, just kind of put their heads down a little bit. I'd like to see them regroup here and make this more of a game. So let's see what happens here. Hey, Texas needs a big defensive stop here, Coach.
And this, you know, this starts from the top down, and I'm just looking at the demeanor right now of the staff, and the staff is despondent. The kids are despondent, you know. They're just, you know, and that's almost why you call that timeout, because, you know, just to reel them in and remind them why you're here.
I'll tell you what, though, the effort is still there by Texas. They are playing as hard as they can, especially with the ball down on the ground. Like, look at 37 here, fighting off that alley dodge. So the effort's there. They just got to start stringing it together and see how it goes here. Colorado driving.
I agree. It's just, you know, that's why we say, you know, it takes the entire team, you know, and the weakest link. It's just what's going on over here next to us. It's not indicative of what's going on the field. They're playing hard on the field, but there's no support coming from
absolutely.
From their
bench. Even when Colorado's on offense, you hear their bench calling out, echoing the offensive plays.
Yes.
So that's fairly important.
Much different, you know, much
all
different.
All the loose balls popping into Colorado's stick right now. As hard as Texas is playing, they just can't seem to get one to bounce into their stick. So we're under a minute here in the third quarter, 11-4 Colorado, and they're maintaining possession here. And here's that chant from the bench, feet inside.
A nice little quick stick.
So the Colorado bench, they count off a three count, and they all scream the offensive play. Really good strategy, so everybody's all together on the same page here. Twenty-five seconds. Move down the alley. Comes in front. There's a flag down. Colorado still with the ball.
We might get another flag down here in a second.
He maintains the ball. Great job getting away from trouble. Number 7 shoots. Ball still in play.
I think I want to hold this right now. Well, okay.
So there is 6 seconds on the clock. I saw 8. Now, Colorado, Coach, has an extra man.
Yeah.
Now, the unique thing with the game of lacrosse is if they actually hold on to the ball here and have possession when the clock runs out to 0, they will start the fourth quarter with the ball. So let's see how long this penalty is. One-minute penalty. So if you hold the ball for 6 seconds, you start the fourth quarter with 54 seconds of extra man offense and a 7-goal lead, Coach.
Right. Yeah, it's going to, you know, you don't even risk in this case. You just go up here, you run away, you know. I wouldn't even be passing the ball. I'd be So that's the end of the third, and we're sitting on a Colorado sitting on 11-4 lead right now.
Effort by number 27, dodging around the goal from Max, left-handed, and a goal to make it 11-5 Colorado. Sorry, that was 37 with the goal. Texas, great effort.
James Mills. James Mills with an individual effort, you know, and that's just what we talked about. It's you know, one chip at a time. And
the next play here is the ground ball. Let's see if the Texas Longhorns can get it. And it comes up Colorado.
The face-offs has been an Achilles heel all day. You know, they've struggled. They've thrown multiple people out there. It's just something that they just can't seem to capitalize on right now. And it's gonna. That's you know that with you know with one quarter left and down six. That's gonna be a real tough. Hurdle to clear, even if you're going and you're scoring, you know, in a 1 minute clip, but you're not winning those faceoffs, then you know they're gonna come down and they're gonna take their minute and a half, 2 minutes of possession
time.
Here
comes the offense again, moving the ball. Great look, great off stick save low by the Texas goalkeeper.
I don't know if they needed that right now, Coach. You know, like it was.
Ball gets thrown down the field by the Texas goalkeeper. That's going to go out the far end line, so that's going to be Colorado ball. Colorado clearing. Colorado seems to be a little confused in their clearing game, and they hit a midi.
Yeah, it's a little... Texas is showing a little bit of a zone ride, which isn't a bad idea sometimes. It doesn't allow you that easy pass up the middle, but it also, again, takes time. You know, and right now, time is not on your side. It's got to be all hands on deck, and it's got to be an aggressive ride at this point in time.
Absolutely. Here comes Colorado. That's 22 again at X. His comfortable spot. He just feeds to 12. Shot.
Nice save. Nice save.
Here comes Texas on the attack again, trying to clear the ball. Let's see what they can do. On 11-5 game, Texas scoring the last goal.
Yeah, you know, Jordan Lee has had a good game. It's just, you know, he's seen a lot of rubber today.
Absolutely.
The shot count.
Here comes
count,
the pass, Texas.
The shot count.
It's in the box
for
Texas.
Colorado.
Texas picks it up here. They're going to be on offense. They got to start making things happen fast, and I think they realize that. Here comes Dodge from Texas, 22. Left-handed shot, missed wide. Not a bad take.
Not a bad take. Just needed to, you know, kind of ran his angle out. Probably should have taken the shot a couple steps sooner.
It was a good lift by the Colorado defenseman, too. Texas subbing out a guy in the midfield, bringing in number 15.
Yeah, nobody's looking at him.
Inside roll to 28. He gets checked low. Looks like he's hurting.
Yeah, he
moves the ball off.
He took a hard one. He's going to let the referee know.
Here comes 15. Ollie Dodge throws down hard. Stop and go move at X. Number 8 puts it in his left hand, passes it back up top. Up to number 12. 22 on the wing. Hitch and go back to his right hand. Back over to 8. 12 with a big bounce shot and a goal and a flag.
I think that was a great.
So that's a late hit there. So that's a big, just like we talked about. Bouncing that ball at the top of the dirt, top of the crease, took a big, nice jump up to the top shelf of the goal. We have an 11-6. We should have an extra man face-off here. And, hey, Texas is right back in this thing right now.
That is going to be no face-off. They're going to get the ball because it came
after
the goal.
You're right. So that's going to be Texas with the ball.
Josh Francis, great individual shot and won an Academy Award for a fall and now Texas capitalizes.
Hey, I tell you what, you know, it's the N1 tour, baby. Go
absolutely.
And take it. Get your goal and take the extra man. Let's see if he can put another one in. I mean, they score here, Coach. It's 11-7.
Yeah.
You have 10 minutes.
Yeah.
And 10 minutes and 30 seconds left to play
here. That's forever.
This is
it.
This is it right here. This is the game of lacrosse. That's why it's the greatest game in the world, because no matter what, it's a game of runs, and you could always come back.
Yes. I, and, you know, the – looks like they're choosing to string on a the five man.
Yep.
So the low and the low corner should be open, but they're running a wheel.
It looks like they adjusted their set based on how they're playing it. Step in, 37, moving the ball down to 12, over to 29, right-handed wheel. Comes back, shot, big bounce shot from 12, goes wide.
I like the take. I don't like the offense right now for the defense that they're running.
Here comes the ball, moving it again, still in the EMO, 12 low, cuts back to 6. Shot hits the outside of the goal. We like to call that a mama's goal because all the moms in the stands, they cheer, and the ball's on the side of the net. So no goal, and now we got Colorado here on the man down clear. Takes on his attackman, carries it over.
Penalty's about to expire.
Colorado is offsides. The referee is counting and has not blown the whistle, and they allowed it to go. So Colorado gets away with one there. They were offsides there for about 5-10 seconds. And by the time he counted, they had a guy back. So Colorado sneaks away with a clear there that was offsides. So Colorado maintains possession. We got 9 minutes here, 11-6, a 5-goal advantage for Colorado. So, Coach, you think you just take long possessions here, try to kill the clock a little bit with a 5-goal lead?
5-goal lead, I don't think I'm sitting just yet.
Okay.
With 9 minutes left, I still want to be aggressive. You know, I don't want to be, you know, overly.
Take what they give you, right?
That's what I don't want right
okay.
there. I don't want cut passes, and I don't want dodges and feet in behind, you know, behind my body. I want just straight, hard, you know, alley dodges, throw down, throw back.
Number
good
eight right
shot
there.
Right there. Nothing wrong with that. They
shoot
away
from the corners.
Yeah, you know.
Got back up. And here comes Colorado calling out 21. So they're in their 21 set. That's 2 low attackmen, 1 in the crease, 3 middies up top and an umbrella.
And I like it. It's a safe set. You know, it's a safe set to work out of. It gives you space.
Around the outside.
Right. You know,
So here they come, dodging this alley again with 55, who's the initiator, comes to his middle, to his left hand.
Wow.
Great off-stick save by the Texas goalie.
Really did. He really jumped all over that. You know, when a goalie's able to really step into that off-hip side, that means he's seeing it well.
Loose ball down in the offensive end of the Texas Longhorns. Battle for the ground ball. One body gets laid out there. Comes up Colorado. They change fields, and it should be an easy walk out here. 24, long pole carries it over. He's coming hard down the alley, left-handed, Coach. And we have a timeout call by Colorado. That is a great call by their coach.
Yeah.
Saving possession, saw a long pole carrying down, getting in trouble, had a lot of pressure on his hands, calls a timeout. Now they'll be able to come out of this timeout with 7.5 to go, up 5, and the ball.
Yeah, absolutely. Their attack just worked really, really hard in that last possession, carrying and trying to use that clock. So you certainly won't, you know, the timeout is well positioned at 7 minutes and 30 seconds left. They still have one left, and this is a safety timeout. Right now he's going to hone his offense in, and he's going to tell them, keep their spacing. Don't do anything stupid. Take what they give you. You know what? And right now it's okay to move that ball around until you get that keep it in call. There's nothing wrong with that. You know, just still be aggressive and don't fall out of your rhythm when that happens.
So here we come back out of the timeout, 7.5 remaining here in beautiful, sunny Greenville, South Carolina. Thanks again to Lax World and the city of Greenville for putting on such a great MCLA Division I and Division II national tournament. I mean, it is getting close to 5:30 p.m. and the sun is just as nice as it was at 10 a.m. right now.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, have to have sunscreen
my base,
on up here.
My base is great. Yeah. I'm 3 shades away from Fire Engine Red.
Here comes Colorado in an open set. Looking to keep the ball on the outside here.
Texas not putting any pressure on the ball. Looks like they're in zone.
Yeah, this is what you can't do right now. It's just
Texas is allowing Colorado to pass the ball around with a 5-goal lead and 7 minutes remaining in the fourth quarter. Texas sitting back in their zone. Colorado moving the ball.
Unless we see a rover come out of this, unless they're running a 5-man and you're going to see a rover come out and attack somebody, they're letting Colorado waste time right now.
Big save by the Texas goalkeeper. Ball goes out through the end line. Colorado picks it up. Big shot and a save by the Texas goalkeeper. And here comes Texas, 6.5 remaining in the fourth quarter, down 5 goals.
You know what, Nero, right now,
he's pushing it hard.
I need trailers. I need to change fields.
And there's a bad pass that goes out of bounds, and that's going to go back to Colorado. Coach, no pressure, just throwing the ball away.
Yeah, and it just goes back to what I just said. All I just asked for, and I'm playing coach here, is trailers for my Dodger. And the reason is so that when he does turn around, he's making a 10-yard, 15-yard pass, not a 30-yard, 40-yard pass, which he just tried to make. And isn't going to happen to guys that are standing flat-footed.
Shot went out wide. Colorado retains possession. Hopefully that fan's okay. Looks like she got hit laying down over there on the sideline. That's the thing. These fans are real close on that far sideline.
Yeah, that's a dangerous angle.
They're a couple yards away. So, talking about collisions over there, and earlier in our first game, we had somebody playing real hard that actually took a body check and went over the fence. So they got to stay alert over there, that's for sure.
Yeah, the fans really shouldn't be below the restraint line. It's a bad angle.
And there's going to be a flag down. We got an offside from Colorado. Just took a step off. So he's going to come over, and they're going to have an extra defender here. So it's going to have 7 defenders and 6 offensive players for Texas. Quick double. Texas moving the ball. Ball's still loose. Texas comes up with it. They'll still be able to play here, and they are. And then they throw it. Out of bounds.
It's mind-boggling, Coach. We look at it through different glasses right now because we're not down on the field. But boy, the frustration that you get just as a spectator. Can you imagine what their coaching staff is feeling right now, watching their players throw 40-yard passes over guys' head?
Yeah, absolutely. It's definitely frustrating, especially when you're down some goals here. And that was a free possession there where you go to the goal, you get a goal, now it's extra man. So they're going to be up for 30 seconds here. Let's see if Texas can bring them within 4. Ball movement.
So now they're in a traditional 5-man rotation, and they're not they're back to stringing again. So you want that short
loose
corner.
Loose ball behind. Texas comes up with it. Steps in, holds the shot.
But nobody's
they're
just
10
not
in the penalty. Feed inside to number 2 and a goal. Or is that 12? That is number 12 on the left-handed goal down in the low corner
Josh
to make it
Francis.
11-7. Coach, 11-7, 4 minutes, 36 seconds left in the game. This is very doable.
If I'm Texas, I'm a lot more excited than what I'm seeing.
Yeah, Colorado scored a goal in a while here. So Texas has really weathered the storm, playing great defense. If they can limit their turnovers in the middle of the field, it'll fare better for them on offense. Let's see if they can win this draw here. Texas wins it out, and they get the ground ball. So let's see if they can get in their offensive end. This is big here, Coach.
That's huge because that's the first face-off that I've seen Texas win cleanly.
And there's now we got another penalty down.
I don't understand what the whistle.
Did the white just call a timeout? I believe Texas got in the box, and he called a timeout with a flag down. Which I'm sure he wish he had that back because I'm sure he didn't see the flag.
I certainly wouldn't have called that.
So 4:21 left in the fourth quarter. It looks like Texas is going to be on extra man.
Yeah, Texas did, in fact, call a timeout with a flag down.
Okay, so we got a hold on number 6, the Colorado attackman, for 30 seconds. So Texas scores here on EMO, Coach. That makes it 11-8. This is still a ball game.
Still a ball game, and the only problem is here now Texas is out of timeouts.
Okay. So he needs to give the instructions, really, for the rest of the game right here, outside of what you do on extra man. It needs to be, okay, guys, this is what we're doing on extra man. All right, next faceoff, this is how we're lining up.
Yeah.
When we win that faceoff, this is what we're doing offensively. If we lose that faceoff, this is what we're doing defensively. Yeah. You got to prepare them for five different situations in that last timeout.
And our
Because the only other timeout you get is what Colorado calls.
That's right. Yeah, I mean, really most importantly is how are you going to play that ride right after? What are you going to do? And I haven't seen Texas have I've watched him drop into the zone. I haven't watched him play on a real aggressive ride until the ball hits the ground.
Okay, so Texas with the ball in that far left wing here. They're in a 1-3-2 to start this, and you're going to get that five-man string again with the Colorado defense with 11 string in the crease and up top to top center. So let's see what Texas does here. They got lefties and righties flipping spot. They go with the fake flip. Ball sticks with the lefty. And it passes off his back foot, gets deflected, and now Colorado comes up with a ground ball. Coach, that's just unforced turnovers again.
It comes down to fundamentals. If you're standing flat-footed and you pass the ball, it's going to be a bad pass. If you're standing flat-footed and you receive the ball, it's not going to come to your stick the right way, and you're not going to be able to do what you want to do.
Big clear by the Colorado defender. Now that we are all even, Colorado has the ball with 3:40 left in this fourth quarter and a four-goal advantage. I think it's possession time.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, I mean, it's now ball control.
If they put the timer on us, so be it.
Yes.
So be it. You know, clock right now, killing minutes is more important than scoring more goals.
I'll take the 30 seconds and roll in the corner.
Absolutely. So let's see how long the referees wait here, because Colorado's been keeping the ball up top here. Coming hard to the goal now. Get it back down behind. 15 moves it out top to 55. He gets to the middle of the field. Shot left-handed, wide, staying Colorado. So that may have kept the timer going on there right there with that big hard dodge to the goal. Colorado with the ball, moving back up top. Big shot, wide. Colorado backing it up.
This is very safe right now. I don't think. These aren't shots that are shots to score. These are possession shots, but it's going to keep these refs from
Texas got to get out on pressure, Coach. They're playing that zone again.
Yeah, it's too late for that.
Ball down. 15 picks it up for Colorado. Timeout, goal.
There's down that. That's
2:30 remaining in the fourth quarter. 11-7, Colorado lead. They'll come back out of the timeout with the ball and a four-goal lead.
With fresh legs.
Coach, what do you think about if you're the Texas defensive coordinator, you're down four goals, there's 2.5 minutes, the ball's in the back right corner. Do you start with a double on the ball here?
Absolutely. Yeah, I'm pulling my goalie out of the front of the cage. I'm finding the slowest matchup I can find with my goalie, having him shut off, and then I'm sending two poles to the ball.
Okay, so let's see what Texas does here. They got a lot of communication going on in the huddle. They got the Longhorns up. They're about to break, and let's see what happens here. And here we come back, remaining 2.5 minutes of the fourth quarter.
Doesn't look like they're gonna double the ball here, Coach. I just don't get it.
I don't even see a guy out on the ball right now. They have him packed in. Now he's taking a step out closer. So, yeah, they're going to stick one guy on him. They're not doubling the ball here.
I can't say, you know, that.
They are pressuring up top. Here comes number 8 with the ball. Passes it over to wing. Big shot by number 3. That goes wide. Colorado backs it up. 2:21 remaining in the fourth quarter now.
I give Colorado credit. These are not, like I said, these are not shots to score. Now that one. But
big save by the Texas goalkeeper. Let's see if they need to start pushing it. They got to start going to goal here. And they got to go early and often. Texas midfielder number 18 carrying it through traffic. Gets it down the side. Gets a touch in the box. He's going hard at the goal. And the feed goes out of bounds, and that's going to be Colorado ball again.
We don't have the running stat count up here. I have to say that Texas is upwards of 25 turnovers.
And there's going to be a feed that just the low attackman missed it. If he would have caught it, he would have been on the doorstep with a shot. So here comes Texas back down again on the clear. And they have a minute and a half left, and they are down 4 goals. And there's a pass that just deflects off the defender, sticking out of bounds. It's going to go back to Colorado. Another unforced turnover here. It's been the story of the game here, folks.
Yeah, it really, face-offs and unforced turnovers, really, Coach. It's been, the game started out very, very even. I thought both teams...
Here comes the double call. Black is their double call. They're sending 2 to the ball.
2 to the ball with the goalie in the cage, though. I just it's just going to always leave somebody open. And
Colorado pushes it to the middle of the field. There's a flag down. And that's going to be a hold on the Texas defense, and that's not going to be a good situation here. 56 seconds left in the game. Colorado's going to be man up for 30 of it. And they got a full goal lead, so this is going to be tough here.
Now I'm putting, this is a situation, Coach, where I'm still putting my first man up in because you're playing championship weekend.
Absolutely.
And they need the reps.
Yep.
You know, so in this situation, unfortunately, you want to be good sportsmen, but this is a situation where you got to try to score, because. You're moving on to bigger and better things at this point. And
no pressure on ball. The goalie came out of the cage when the ball was getting close to GLE. As soon as it came above GLE, the goalie went back into the cage. So let's see if he keeps with it. Okay, it's above GLE. He's staying in the cage. Gets down. Here comes the goalie. They're going to kill the man up. So here we go. So now they're released. So now we're even. Now we're even here, and Colorado's not making a move to the goal. They're still stalling. And there we are down
to 10. He can run all the way to his offensive, his defensive side right now.
10 seconds remaining here.
He might as well.
7. They just chuck it down in the corner. That's a loose ball. And that's game.
That's the
Colorado
game.
Winning 11-7, and they will advance to the second round of the Division I MCLA National Championship Playoff Tournament.
Coach Barrett, I think just from watching...